American Trumpet Advisory following the NATO summit in Brussels. Later today, Prime Minister Theresa May's country home in Oxford, and later today, at Windsor Castle. Nor now, AP's Charles Bonds in London. On Monday, President Trump will be holding a summit with Washington President Vladimir Putin in Helsinki. President Trump says he's received a very strong support from leader Kim Jong-un. Praise of the efforts, one that you can improve relations between the two countries. Yet the joint statement signed by the leaders for the summit in June. This follows U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo's meeting last week in Pyongyang, regarding the North nuclear program. Syrian state media described the talks with Pompeo as regrettable. An explosion rocked the chemical factory in Kairo Airport late Thursday, prompting firefighters on the scene. The rest of the scene local media reported simple injuries, but no deaths were reported. This is VOA News. The Syrian government has raised the national flag over areas of Deraa city that have been in rubble for years and is being seen as a major victory for President Bashar al-Assad in the birthplace of revolt against his rule. Meantime, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu meeting in Moscow this week with Russian President Vladimir Putin. The last focus on Iran's presence in Syria. University scholar David Hush says it's only natural for Israel to forge closer ties with Russia on this issue.
And so Russia is being acknowledged clearly as the main power broker in Syria.
Oversight committee chair Kerry Dowdy says it's not strange to start with the Russian investigation.
Do you remember how long it took for you to start talking about impeachment after Donald Trump was appointed?
I don't, sir.
One day, Peter Strzok said his views don't reflect his work.
At no time in any of these texts did those personal beliefs ever
any action I took, and that the fact that he could get away with what the judiciary can imagine
deeply corrodes what the FBI is in American society, the effectiveness of their mission, and it is deeply destructive.
Strzok says the Reuters investigation is not a witch hunt, it is not a hoax.
Ed Donahue, Washington.
First Security Council said to vote to bring a resolution that would impose an arms embargo on Taliban and sanctions against the current deputy defense chief and former army chief. Is concerned at the failure of Taliban's leaders to end hostilities. For more news, at our website, you can find us at voanews.com. I'm Steve Borman in Washington. That's the latest world news from VOA. In today's world, sharing the gospel is getting harder and harder. Being able to learn God's word and be able to minister. Sharing the news is also becoming more difficult. If you know you have a call on your life and are seeking to get the needed education and preparation for ministry, look into the Trinity Graduate School and Seminary. Trinity Graduate School and Seminary exists to glorify Jesus Christ.